Hello everyone. In this video, we are going to learn about SQL joins. So let's move on to the topic. So here I have given a definition of join. So join, that is a class. It is a type of class. Last few videos, we have learned about the classes. Aware class, having class. Likewise, we have learned a lot of classes. So this is a continuation of that. So here in this video, we are learning about join class. Okay. So this join class is used to combine rows from two or more tables. Okay. So from two or more tables, we can combine the rows based on some related column or any condition. Okay. So there will be a relation between two columns, right? Based on that relation, we are going to combine the rows from two or more tables. So that process name is called as a join. Okay. So it is a class and it is used to combine rows from two or more tables. Okay. So let's see what are the types available in this join class. So here are the types of join in SQL. First one is a inner join, full outer join, then left join and right join. So about these four joins, we are going to see in detail. So let's move on to the next one. So this is a pictorial representation of types of join. So the first one, this is called as a left join. Just look at this here. They have given the two tables. One is a country table and one is state table. And if it is taken from country table alone, then that will be, both are combining, but the country table is highlighted, right? So whatever is highlighted, that you will get it in the result. So if you are going to join the two tables and in your result you are getting the first table, that is the leftmost table, then that will be called as a left join. Then right join, when you are going to combine the two tables, but you are going to get the result as a rightmost table, that will be called as a right join. Then inner join, in the sense, what is the common part of the two tables? That common part alone you will get as a result. So that will be called as an inner join. Whereas outer join is fully, totally, that two tables that will be combined together and all the attributes and values, whatever available on that two tables, that will be displayed in your result. So that will be called as a full outer join. So this is a pictorial representation. Through these pictures, you can understand the concept easily. Now we will see about the each and every topic in detail, and as well as we are going to learn the syntax, everything. Okay, so let's move on to that. So the first one is a inner join. We are going to learn inner join now. So the definition of inner join is, this SQL inner join keyword, it describes, it is going to select the records that have the matching values in both sides. We know that inner join means it will select that common part, whatever is common between the two tables, that common part alone it will take. So inner join keyword always select the records that have the matching values in both the table. If the values are present in both the table, that will be selected. Okay, that records will be selected and it will be displayed on your output. So here is a join index, syntax of inner join. So the syntax is select, always the query will be started from the word select. So select column name, whatever columns you are going to select, that will be comes under column name, from table one. In this join, where whatever join you are going to perform, you have to mention the two table name, because join in the sense you're going to join the two tables, right? Two or more, it may be a three, four, likewise also, but minimum two table name you have to mention. Okay, so don't forget that. From table one, then the keyword inner join, table two, on table one dot column name is equal to table two dot column name. Okay, so this is the syntax: select column name from table one, inner join table 2, on table 1 dot column name is equal to table 2 dot column name. Both will have the same column, right? That will be based on that the join will be performed. Okay, so let's see the example. So here I have given the pictorial representation of inner joint. Just look at this. Here you have table 1 and here you have table 2. Okay. In this table 1 we have column 1 and column 2. In this table 3 we have column 3 and column 4. So here the column 1 we have 1, 2, 3 and 4. And in this table 2 we have 2, 3, 4, 5. So whatever is common for both 2, 3 and 4 is present on the both the table, right? On both the table we have the ID 2, 3, 4. The numbers 2, 3, 4 is present on both the side. So that is the common, right? That will comes under inner join. Okay. So only the matching rows from the both the left and right tables. That is table 1 and table 2. Understood? So this is the pictorial representation. And so already we have seen this in our beginning slide. So inner join in the sense the two table will be joined together and whatever is a common part, whatever is matched, that alone will be highlighted in your result. Okay. So let's move on to the next one. So again, one more pictorial representation of inner join. Just look at this. Here we have customers table and here we have orders table. Okay. So in this customers table, we have customer ID and name. And in this order table, we have order ID, customer ID and order date. So this customer ID will be the foreign key of this table. Okay. So because through this customer ID only, we can link both of the tables. So now we are going to perform inner join on customer ID. Can you understand what you have to write on? You have to write that foreign key, which will be the link, that column name you have to mention after on in your queries. Okay. So from this customer and order table, we are going to perform an inner join. We know that inner join in the sense we will get the common matching part in your result, right? So here we have the customer ID 123 and here we have 142. So I have highlighted the records whichever is common. 1 and 2 is common. That's why it is highlighted. Now can you understand? So that highlighted values alone, in the sense that matching whatever is common for both, that will be comes to the result. So this will be the result of this inner join. Okay. So in this result, we have all the attributes, that is customer ID, name, order ID, customer ID and order date. Both the table has joined together and the matching, that is the common records, will be displayed over the output. Okay. So 1 and 2 ID is a common one. So that alone has displayed in this result. Now can you understand? So let's move on to the next one. So now we are going to see about the full outer join. Okay. So full outer join, how it will perform. So the keyword full outer join return all the records. Okay. All the records from table 1 and table 2. That is the left and right table. And there will be a match. Okay. So let's see the syntax and example, then you will get it easily. So here is the syntax. Before knowing the syntax, we will learn about the note. There is a note. And this full outer join, it will give us a somewhat huge result, okay? Because full outer join in the sense the table 1, whatever records present, that also will be displayed over the output. And in table 2, what are the records, how many records were present there, that also will be displayed over the output. So the result will be somewhat huge, okay? And one more tip I have given here. So this full outer join, here I have mentioned the name as full outer join. Sometimes it may be called as a full join. Okay. So full outer join and full join, both are same. Let's see the syntax of full outer join. So here I have given a syntax. Just look at this. Select column name from table 1, full outer join, table 2 on table 1 dot column name is equal to table 2 dot column name. In the sense, here we will mention the foreign key. Okay. Where condition. If you want to include a condition over this, you can mention the where class and you can write your conditions. Okay. So this will be the syntax of full outer join. Now this picture is representing a full outer joint. Just look at this, table 1 and table 2 has joined together, and whatever is present on both the tables, that will be displayed over the output. That's why it is fully highlighted, fully colored. Okay, so the pictorial representation of full outer joint is given here. Just look at the same customer table and orders table I have given here. Customer ID, name, and then here three attributes were there, that is order ID, customer ID and order date. And I told you that in this in our previous inner join, I have highlighted the common records alone. I mean here 1 and 3 alone matching, right? 1 and 3 alone is common for both. So that's why that's what highlighted in this inner join. But just look at here, fully highlighted. Here also all three records were highlighted, and here also all three records were highlighted. So in the sense, we know that full outer join, in the sense it is fully will be displayed in the output. But look at here, in this customer ID, in this customers table, we have customer ID is 2 and name is Kalpana. But look at here, there is no customer ID, that is 2. 2 is missing here. So when you are combining both, your result table will be shown like this. Whatever is not present on another table, that will be shown as a null value. Okay. Now can you understand? And here, 4, customer ID 4 is present on orders table, but it is not here on customers table. So that's why it is showing that null here. Okay. If you have see this result table, then you will get to know how it is joined together. Okay. So now here another pictorial representation for full outer join. Just look at this. These two tables are joining, okay, over full outer join. So when it is joined, this user ID is common for both, right? But here 1 and 2 user ID is there, but in this table only customer user ID 1 alone present. So for the next one, for number 2, it will be null value. And here event ID 2 is there. Event ID 2 is there, but there is no user ID and there is no name. So that's why it will be a null value. Okay. So likewise, the full outer join will be performed. So now we are going to compare the inner join versus outer join. Okay. So here is a comparison between the inner join and outer join. So in inner join, what we have learned, whatever is common, whatever is present common for both the table, that alone will be displayed over the output. But if it is a outer join, for example, full outer join, we have learned now, no? So full outer join, whatever records present on both the table, it will be displayed over the result, but that missing values will be shown as a null value. Okay. And if it is a left outer join, it will be joined together, but whatever is present on the leftmost table, that will be displayed over the result. And if it is a right outer join, whatever data will be present on the right side table, that it will be joined together, but whatever is present on the right, it will be displayed over the output. Now we are going to learn this left outer join and right outer join. Already we have seen about full outer join. Now we are going to see these two. Okay. So we will move on to that. So now we are going to see about the right join. It may be called as a right outer join also. So both we have seen, no, full outer join and full join, both are same. Likewise, right outer join and right join, both are same. Okay. So just look at this. So this is a right join. Right join keyword always returns all the records from the right table because it is a right join. So whatever records are present on the table 2, that will be matched with the records from the leftmost table, that is table 1, and it will give the result as null for the leftmost table where there is no match. If doesn't match with the rightmost table, it will be shown as a null value. Okay, and whatever is matched with the right table, that will be shown in the result. So here is the syntax. So before seeing the syntax, Already I told you that right joint and right outer joint both are same. Okay, and here is the syntax. Select column name from table 1, right joint table 2. On table 1 dot column name is equal to table 2 dot column name. Okay, so this is the syntax of right join. Now we will see about the pictorial representation. So it will be easy to understand. So here is a pictorial representation of right outer join or right join. So the same table we have taken, customer table and order table. And here it is 1, 2, 3 customer IDs were present. And here 1, 4, 3 were present. But if it is a right outer join, first it will take all the records from the rightmost table, that is table 2. So whatever is present on order table, it will be shown in the result. And it will check with the table 1, that is customer table. What is common for both 1 and 3? So 1 and 3 will be displayed. It will be joining together. So whatever is present on 1 and 3 on customer table, it will be displayed. But 2 is not present on the order table. That's why it is shown as a null value. Now can you understand? It will join both the table, but whatever is present on the left rightmost table will be displayed over the result. And whatever is matched with the rightmost table from the left table will be displayed over the result. And if it is not matched, it will be shown as a null value. Okay, so let's move on to the next one. So now we are going to see about the left join. Okay, and left join, it return all the records from the left table and the matched records from the right table. All the records from left table will be shown and the matched records from the right table will be shown in the result. Remaining will be shown as a null value. Okay, and left join and left outer join both are same. So let's see the syntax of left join. So the syntax of left join is select column name from table 1, left join table 2. On table 1 dot column name is equal to table 2 dot column name. Okay, so all the syntax will be looking same, only the difference is the keyword. If it is a full outer join, you have to write full outer join. If it is a left join, you have to use the keyword left join. So the keyword alone will be the different. Remaining, the syntax will be remains the same for all the joins. Okay, so let's see the pictorial representation of left join or left outer join. So here I have given two tables, that is table A and table B. Now we are going to perform the left join. So the table has joined together and here 210, 211, 212 and 213 will be present on table A. So this fully will be displayed over the result. Whatever is present on table A will be displayed on the result. And here only 210 and 212 is common. So 214 and 215 is not common. So this 210 and 212 alone will be displayed on the result. This 214 and 215 will be shown as a null value. Okay, so all rows from left table A and matching rows from right table B and unmatched rows from table A and table B I have shown here. Okay, so let's see the next pictorial representation. So the same customer table and order table we have taken. So here this is a left outer join, am I right? So whatever is present on the leftmost table, that is customer table, will be displayed on the result. And whatever records are matched with this will be highlighted here, will be displayed here. And number 4, customer ID 4 is not present on customers table. So it is shown as a null value. Okay, so I hope you all understand the concept of join. And if you have any confusion on this, kindly watch the video again and again, so you will get a clear knowledge on this. In our next video, we are going to learn about EQ join and theta join, natural join. So about this, we will learn about the next videos. So this is the basic of join. So kindly learn the join and try to do more queries. Try to work out more queries, because when you are started practicing more, then it will be very easy to write the query by your own. So thanks for watching. Thank you.